Ghana is set to open Sub-Saharan Africa's first liquefied natural gas to power project as it moves to position itself as a hub for the cleaner and cheaper fuel in the region. Now, this model has been booming from Asian to Latin American in recent years as they allow nations to switch from dirtier fossil fuels to keep the lights on. And for the sellers, integrated LNG to power provides a guaranteed outlet for the fuel. Well, here's what we know at Joy Business. First, that the Tema LNG Terminal Corporation received the floating regasification unit from the Xiangyang, China on Wednesday. This is what we know. Also, we're picking that this paves way for the supply of about 1.7 million tons of natural gas per year for power generation sometime this quarter. Also, we're picking that the $350 million project has been under construction for about 2 years now, backed by Helios Investment Partners and Africa Infrastructure Investment Managers. Also, the fourth tip we're picking is that state-owned Ghana National Petroleum Corporation is currently the mandatory off-taker who received regasified LNG to four plants in the Tema Palm and Industrial Enclave. This is big. This means so much for Ghana's energy industry. And to answer the question of what exactly this holds for the sector, we are joined via Zoom by Dr. Yusuf Sulemana. He is an energy strategist and an expert in global energy geopolitics. He's also the lead technical consultant for COPEC GH. We're so grateful, Doc, that you joined us. Happy New Year to you. First of all, for a country with 30 million people, you know, Ghana's electricity consumption has grown alongside its economy, but, you know, it remains lower than the average per capita consumption of Sub-Saharan Africa. Why this project then, some may ask, when indeed we are doing it all good in the electricity sector?
Yeah, thank you very much, and thank you for having me. Good afternoon to your cherished viewers around the globe and your cherished listeners as well. Yeah, so that's a very good question that you've asked. The question is, why this kind of project? Now, I'll just try to explain to you in principle what this kind of project means and its impact to, you know, Ghana power supply. Regasification unit is simply just gasifying LPG or natural gas. That's what we normally call the LNG.
Okay.
You know, to make it at the state that can power plants readily. Now, over the years, where are we coming from? Over the years, Ghana has always been dependent on heavy fuel sources, you know, to generate power, largely. A component of it is crude oil and RFO, that is a residual fluid oil. Now, these sources, unfortunately, are imported into the country. It creates a lot of burden on the economy. It creates a lot of, you know, pressure on the city. Now, to the extent that we're going to have a structure that will be within our shores, that to be able to provide this quantum of gas, LNG, which is largely methane, let's say 90% methane, okay, you know, which is cleaner, fresher, and more purer at competitive rates, you know, to power our power industries. That would be great.
Interesting.
Now, you remember the history about IPP. Why do IPP came to light? IPP came because industries were ready for power, but there was virtually no supply of power. In fact, domestic consumption for power was not even available, and that's how come we had Dumso. Now, three things accounted for this. We need power availability, we need power affordability, and we need power dependability. If these three things are not met, we are not going to have sufficient supply of power that will be near to the benefit of the end user.
Well,
now,
sorry to cut you there, but, you know, I just want to also chip in this whole point and even pose the question, to what percentage will the LNG to power project wean Ghana from its dependency from the West Africa gas pipeline and even that of, you know, independent power producers? You rightly stated, you know, the causatives to doom. So where do we see ourselves weaning off from these, you know, power producers in the future?
Yeah, the great thing is, I think the nation is already gravitating, you know, at a very good rate, if I may put it that way.
All right.
I mean, gravitating from a heavy fuel sources of generating power to liquid sources. Now, one of the contributors is WAPCO, that is West African Gas Pipeline. Ghana is able to get gas from West African Gas Pipeline. Now, the coming in of this project is not going to be a one go. It's going to be a transition. We're going to gradually transition. Ghana is going to gradually transition from dependent on this, infrastructure, credible infrastructure that we are told, to dependent on West African gas pipeline. Remember, West African gas pipeline, the supply has been erratic. You know, what percentage Ghana is going to win off, we cannot tell at the moment. Everything will depend on the dependability, ready availability, and affordability of whatever is coming from, the project that we're getting. But the assumption is that the proximity of this project to Tema Enclave, which is housing the industrial hub, the power generation point of Ghana, we believe that the proximity will ensure that power supply to those units will be at competitive rates.
Great.
So by large, I think we expect that we should gradually wean ourselves off from WAPCO.
Great.
But it's going to be gradual, yeah.
Great. Well, the project, we understand, is being financed with a combination of equity and debt from the consortium of international banks. How can government partake of the financial instrument moving forward?
Yeah, the good thing is, I think it's already indicated that our national oil company, that is GMPC, will be the off-taker. Now, GMPC being the off-taker means that we already have, to some extent, some participation as possible.
Right.
But what I like about the project is the fact that, a private sector-led project will always be efficient. It is not a government champion project, if I may put it that way, not directly. Shell is behind that as a supplier. Companies that understand business profitability vis-a-vis what it tends to make profit when you are running business, they are bound to be efficient. So to the extent that, GMPC being the off-taker, Ghana still have some interests, however little it's going to be. But a hybrid model, that is equity and debt, is known to be one of the competitive models. So again, I'm very convinced that with hybrid model, I believe with several players coming to play, others through equity and debt, I think such a model is credible. I believe it's a credible model that will yield to the benefit of the nation.
Great. Let's end on this. When all is said and done, the process LNG is expected to be 30%, 35% cheaper than heavy fuel. Explain how it will impact fuel prices in the country moving forward.
Yeah, that's correct. Generally, LNG, gas-fired, power plants are generally cheaper, cleaner, purer, and competitive price-wise to heavy fuel-fired. Now, if you supply a gas of like $8 per million BTU, that is British thermal unit, it is competitive to oil at $50 per barrel.
All right.
Just imagine 8 against 50. That is so good. And in fact, we can do even as low as, let's say, around $6 million, $6 per British thermal unit, if we are competitive. And so that makes it, at the end of the day, it will reduce, the power the end user pays, the kilowatt power the end user pays, to about 30%. It will translate to about 30% reduction. But again, that will be at competitive rates. Ghana is not going to get it, of course, on a silver platter, let me put it that way, it's going to come in competitive rate. But the good thing is, the market is ready to receive that. And that's the beautiful about the beauty of the whole thing. Once the market is ready to receive that, it means that there is ready supply. So yes, there will be reduction because gaseous fired power plants are always competitive price-wise as compared to liquid fired power plants.
We're so grateful that you joined us, Dr. Sulemana there. He's an energy strategist helping us break down Ghana's 350 million LNG to power project.